the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Today, we celebrate the fifth Easter Sunday. And the month of May is due to our beloved Mother Mary. Today, at St. Joachim, we celebrate May Crown. And today we celebrate Mother's Day. Let us praise our merciful God for the precious gift of motherhood. And let us pray for all our mothers. Lord, we love and honor the great sacrificial love of our beloved mothers, the living and the dead. Our Blessed Virgin Mary is the mother of all mothers. Mother Mary, our Blessed Mother, help all our mothers to have your sacrificial and serving love in their hearts. And this Mass is offered for Gail Martin, the beloved wife of Dick Martin. And with a heavy heart, let you know the passing of Anna Parker. She died today morning. And they are planning to have the funeral service on coming Wednesday. Let us keep in our heart Anna Parker and their family in our prayers. And today, we have two wedding anniversaries. Yesterday, Steve and Barbara Sullivan celebrated their 47th wedding anniversary. And today, Don and Dot Cipher celebrate their wedding anniversary. And on this week, we have two birthdays. Tomorrow, on Sunday, Lee Gregg celebrates his birthday. And on 12th Tuesday, Mike Abraham celebrates his birthday. Let us pray for a moment. Let us offer the whole world, our nation, our parish family, all our families, our dear ones, all our beloved mothers, all our personal intentions into the hands of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, we gather today to crown this image of Mother Mary, as we acclaim Mary, the Mother of God, as our Queen and the Mother of the Church, let us imitate her example and be attentive to the Word of God. As we honor Mary, let us pray that through her intercession we may achieve holiness of life and a deepened faith, hope, and love, as we seek to do the will of God in all things. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Kevin. God bless you. Let us acknowledge all our sins and so prayer to celebrate this sacred mystery. I confess
Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done
and what I have failed to do.
Through my most grievous heart. Therefore, I ask the Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Amen.
number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men, filled with the Spirit and wisdom, whom shall we appoint to this task, whereas we devote ourselves to prayer and to ministry of the word." The proposal was accepted to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with spirit and with faith and the Holy Spirit. Also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch to convert Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the numbers of the disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
Lord, have mercy on us as we place our trust in you.
Exalt you just in the Lord. Praise from the upright is fitting. Give thanks to the Lord on the harp. With a 10-string lyre, chant his praises. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. See, the eyes of the Lord are upon us, upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness to deliver them from death. They preserve them in spite of famine. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. Reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices, acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in the scripture, "Behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone, chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, its value is for you who have faith, but those without faith. The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, a stone that will make people stumble, and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of the darkness into his wonderful light." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you're going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show me us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I don't know how many of you may have noticed, but the gospel reading today is one of the ones that we use at funerals. I think it comes at a most appropriate time, because many of our fellow citizens have been dying from the coronavirus. And there are a lot of discussions in the news and elsewhere that not only are people dying, but our whole economic system and the livelihood of so many Americans is also dying. There's a lot of uncertainty out there. We haven't seen anything like this since 1918. And the whole world is seeking a way forward, a way out, a way that we can save ourselves from this dreaded disease and death. We're all beginning to sound a lot more like St. Thomas in today's gospel. How can we know the way? Well, I'm here to tell you that long before anyone had ever heard of the coronavirus, Ebola, SARS, the bubonic plague, or any other diseases, there were plagues and pestilence that were killing hundreds of thousands of people. And some of those are even mentioned in the Old Testament. You know, the human race has been trying to find a way to rid itself of diseases and illnesses and death for a long, long time. And by the grace of God, our scientific community has found cures and miracle drugs to ward off so many diseases. But they just keep coming. 24 even tells us that there will continue to be pestilence and plagues right up until the end of time. What then are we to rely on? Is there a way to live in confidence regardless of all the turmoil that comes with these horrible pandemics? Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." Well, what does that mean? Does it mean that we will not have to suffer? Does it mean that we won't catch the virus? You see, here is the confusion that we have as Christians. And this is the reason that so many of us are sounding a lot like Philip in the gospel reading too. We forget that we are following a man who is leading us to Golgotha. We forget that he said we would have to take up our crosses if we were to join him in his resurrection. Have I been with you for so long? For so long a time? And you still do not know me, Philip? Jesus might be asking us that same question. Have I been coming to you all this time in Eucharist, and yet you still do not know me? You still do not trust me? You still yearn to follow the easy way? Not my way. The Catholic Church understands the way of Jesus to be loving, joyful, peaceful, and yet sacrificial. In fact, we see in today's reading from Acts just that kind of sacrifice, but that kind of peace and that kind of joy. Because this new way of loving and sacrificing and sharing was growing very fast. So the apostles decided to add 7 men to take over the duties of distributing to the widows and offering the food that they had. And these 7 new servants, Diakonos in Greek, became the first deacon. And the apostles laid hands on them, and it was a very joyful occasion, just as all baptisms and confirmations and marriages and ordination are all joyful occasions filled with joy. And just as the resurrection of Jesus and the Easter celebration that we're having right now is a joyful celebration. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! He has risen. But with every one of those sacraments comes an opportunity to carry our crosses and witness to what we believe. And if you read on in that same chapter of Acts, you will hear that one of those deacons, St. Stephen, made the ultimate sacrifice when he was stoned to death for preaching the truth. And throughout his ordeal there, and the scripture says that Stephen's face seemed like that of an angel. Talk about peace. And what effect did Stephen's witness have on the early church? The people throwing those stones at Stephen were piling their cloaks at the feet of a young man named Saul. A seed was being planted by Stephen. A seed was being planted in a person who hated the new way. And this man would eventually become the great evangelist, St. Paul. Yes, there is a lot of uncertainty out there, and it may not get any better. But we community of believers, we Catholic Christians, we should know the way. We are a chosen race, Scripture tells us, a royal priesthood, a people who follow Jesus Christ, who are called, who has called us out of darkness into his wonderful light. And all will go well if we follow his way, his light, his truth. Whether it is in joy-filled times or sorrow-filled times. Can I get an amen?
Amen. Amen.
I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, he was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became a man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is Lord and Lord glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one Holy Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray. Our risen Lord, in the midst of our sorrows and sufferings, crisis and uncertainty, in the midst of our fears and frustrations, test us. Do not be afraid. Do not let your heart be troubled. Have faith in God. I am the truth, the life, and the way. Let us gather on our prayers and intentions into the hands of the Lord.
In today's gospel, Jesus tells us, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. Let us pray for the grace to hear more clearly the voice of Jesus in our daily lives, so that we too can come through him to the Father. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In this month of May, we ask Mary, our mother, to pray for us to God, the Father of mercies, that this great suffering may end, and that the families of the sick and the victims be comforted and supported by the love of friends and neighbors. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this Mother's Day, for the gift of motherhood, that all might treasure and support God's plan for life and love. For all mothers, that their children will honor their many sacrifices by lives of service and virtue, and that they be supported and encouraged in their special vocation of love for others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, now hear our prayer.
We pray for the sick and the elderly who at this time may be in hospital or homebound, isolated and unable to see or be with their loved ones. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who have lost loved ones, especially Gail Martin, during this time of crisis, and who have been unable to be with them, grieve with them, and be comforted by friends and community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We bow our heads and remember in silence our own personal intentions and the intentions of those who have asked for our prayers.
Let's pray together to our beloved Mother of our mothers.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
God of everlasting mercy, bless the whole world, our nation, all my brothers and sisters all over the world, those who are suffering from coronavirus. Save us from the spreading of coronavirus. Bless our parish families. All my brothers and sisters, those who are unable to attend Holy Mass in the church. Bless all our beloved mothers. All our beloved children. Blessed Mother, Mother of all mothers, help all mothers to be the good models in their life. Bless all my brothers and sisters to have love, peace, and hope in our Lord. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of our creation, for the goodness we have received, the bread we offer you, food of the earth, and open hands, It will be them for us throughout life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of our creation, for the goodness we have received, the wine we offer, fruit of the vine, and from hence it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice was very acceptable, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of his holy church.
Let us pray. O merciful God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, then we pray that, as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is through your right and just, our duty of salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, has taken away the sins of the world, by dying, has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with us in joy, every land, every people, access in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing to the recumbent hymn of your glory as they acclaim. At the time he was betrayed and accepted his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, every desire for a sin. Take this all of you and drink from it, for this is a touch my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you are worthy to be a presence and minister to you. From your blood, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and with the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, our bishops, our clergy, and our people. Remember your servants, Will Martin, Anna Parker, whom you were from this world universal. Remember also our brothers and sisters for last week in the hope of the resurrection, and all for their mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us, are we free? Daughter of the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints of priestly from the ages, we may merit to be best life and may praise and glorify the Son Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, and Almighty Father, we need the Holy Spirit, our glory, in honor is yours, forever and ever. Grant peace in our days, that by the humble mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from our distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who surpasses peace I live, my peace I give, look not on our sins, but on the faith of our church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in the presence of him who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Before the Lamb of God, before the King who takes away the sins of the world, thus are those for the supper of the Lamb. et speculer, o sacrament vostri holy,
o sacrament divine,
all praise and all thanks to thee,
be there for a moment of time.
We believe that Jesus Christ is really, truly, and substantially present and holy in me. Body, blood, soul, and divinity.
O sacrament most holy,
O sacrament divine,
all praise and all thanks to thee,
be there for a moment of time.
My dear brothers and sisters, thank you, Deaconabby, Mike, for serving the altar and for your wonderful coming. And thank you, Branji. Thank you, Pat, for doing the readings of the day. And thank you, Steve and Barbara, for singing. And thank you, all of you, for coming this holy mass. Let us continue our prayers. Let's pray. Graciously we present to your people, we pray our Lord, and lead those you have endured with heavenly mysteries to pass from for our race to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make your heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come out on you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in peace. Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.
My dear friends in Jesus, thank you all of you once again, and God bless you. Have a great week to you all.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.